Well, it's been a couple weeks and we finally have our very own ReMarkable Paper Pro. And I'll tell you, I was excited from day one to see this device. Matter of fact, a few months ago, we did a video about our predictions of what the ReMarkable 3 was gonna look like. And if you wanna watch that video, check it out here. We had tons of different input on what people wanted for the ReMarkable 3, all the different features. So check out the comments. There's a lot of great ideas and conversation that took place. So when I finally saw the ReMarkable 3, now called, or third generation ReMarkable Paper Pro, I was highly excited, slightly disappointed. So as I started to unbox this device and look at it, the things that really intrigued me was the form factor, the larger display, the little bit of edging that they put into the device itself, the portfolio, the keyboard folio was brilliant how this lays out. But what really intrigued me was the fact that we now have a backlit device and we have color. And those are probably some of the highest request things that we saw in our previous edition. But also with that, we have a new screen, a new writing utensil, and we have a faster device. So when it comes to navigating through your device, using an onboard keyboard, or just paging through PDFs, you're gonna see a big improvement. I've been using this device for the last few days, and I'll tell you first and foremost, there's a lot of things I like about it, but I might not necessarily consider this as my first device if I was weighing out the pros and cons between the RM2 and this device. And if you wanna learn what device is best for you, check out this video. We do a comparison of the RM2 versus the Paper Pro model so you can figure out in your pathway which would be the best device for you. But for me as a digital planner, someone that uses this to take my thoughts and ideas and put them on paper and organize my life, this has a lot of big updates. Again, that backlit keyboard and the ability to have color. Now I can do time blocking, I can use color in my graphs and notations, I can use it to express the thoughts and ideas that are most meaningful. And that is one thing about the ReMarkable, it is a distraction-free device. So if we can have a space where we can have our ideas and thoughts and just kind of collect and nurture those ideas and be able to do that in a planner, we're gonna see not only clarity in what we need to achieve, but we're gonna reach new heights in our results. And if you wanna learn how you can use this device for paper planning, go ahead and check out this video and we show you how you can use this device, the tools that it helps you enable paper planning to its fullest. But as I use this device and get the feel of it, I am actually really excited for the updates and wasn't bummed out that not all the ideas that we had that were part of that prediction video didn't come to life. But the ones that they did were definitely meaningful and they definitely moved the product forward. Now, will they hold true for the next several years? Because we've kind of on this 3 to 4 year rotation ReMarkable. We've seen a lot of competition come to market in the last couple of years and bring these same features already to life. I think the ReMarkable with the color and the backlit have definitely provided a higher quality screen. But I think other people over the next few years are definitely not only going to integrate the quality that the ReMarkable has, but they might bring to light some new additions. Now, one thing I wanted to see on here that I actually am disappointed, I wanted to have the ability to download an app like, say, Kindle and bring in my Kindle library. I know I can bring books into this device, but there's something about being able to bring my Kindle library right to the device, like I can in an Onyx Books device, that I can't do in here. That was probably the biggest setback for me, but I understand the idea of introducing other apps into this device can bring more distraction into your workflow, and that is what ReMarkable is all about, removing that distraction. Go ahead, check out the videos in the link to the description. If you guys wanna learn more about the ReMarkable as we continue to move forward, go ahead and follow me, Brandon Bonifer, creator and founder of the Key to Success Planner. We'll see you in the next one.